Germany developed some of the most advanced weapons technology in the world during World War II. Rockets, jet engines, and advanced aeronautics were among the innovations developed by the Nazi war machine. However, as the war came to an end, the Allies were determined to obtain these cutting-edge innovations. They were concerned that these technologies, as well as the knowledge behind them, would fall into the hands of the Soviet Union. That's when the US government launched a covert operation to find and bring the scientists and engineers behind these technologies to the US. This operation was called Operation Paperclip. Operation Paperclip's primary objective was to relocate as many German scientists and engineers to the United States as was practically possible. The United States government wanted to ensure that the knowledge gained by these scientists and engineers, who had worked on some of the most cutting-edge technologies developed during the war, would not be lost. They also desired to guarantee that these scientists and engineers would be unable to carry on working for the Soviet Union in any capacity in the future. The operation ended up being a success. More than 1,500 German scientists and engineers were relocated to the United States of America. They contributed to the development of a wide variety of projects, such as the Redstone and Jupiter missiles, the U-2 spy plane, and the SR-71 Blackbird. The work that they did would go on to play an important part in both the Cold War and the space race that preceded it. However, some of these scientists had a dark history. They were complicit in atrocities committed against civilians and violations of human rights during World War II. They had been members of the Nazi Party, as well as the SS, and they had been involved in the inhumane treatment of prisoners in concentration camps. Several scientists were recruited through Operation Paperclip, who were involved in war crimes and human rights violations during World War II. Here are a few noteworthy examples. Wernher von Braun was a German rocket scientist and aerospace engineer in Nazi Germany. He was a key figure in the development of the V-2 rocket. Which the Germans used to bomb cities during World War II.
To London goes the dubious distinction of being the first spot on Earth to be bombarded from space. The V-2 was indeed a weapon of vengeance.
Von Braun and his team of scientists and engineers were captured by the Allies and brought to the United States as part of Operation Paperclip at the end of the war. Wernher von Braun joined NASA shortly after its inception and was instrumental in the development of the agency's space program. He was the chief designer of the Saturn V rocket, which launched the Apollo missions to the moon. and he also helped shape NASA's early space exploration plans. He rose to prominence in American space exploration and received widespread acclaim for his contributions to the American space program. Von Braun worked for the US government on a variety of projects, including the development of the Redstone and Jupiter missiles. Von Braun was not without controversy, despite his reputation as a brilliant scientist and engineer. Some have criticized him for his Nazi Party membership and involvement in the use of forced labor in the production of the V-2 rocket. Nonetheless, his contributions to American technology and space exploration cannot be overstated, and he remains one of the most influential figures in space exploration history.
I myself and everybody you see here have decided to go west, and I think our decision was not one of expediency but a moral decision. We knew that we had created a new means of warfare, and the question as to what nation, to what victorious nation we are willing to entrust this brainchild of ours was a moral decision more than anything else. We wanted to see the world spare another conflict such as Germany had just been through, and we felt that only by surrendering such a weapon to people who are guided by the Bible could such an assurance to the world be best secured.
Arthur Rudolf was the V-2 rocket program's chief engineer and a key figure in Operation Paperclip. He was in charge of the production of the V-2 rockets at the Mittelwerk factory, which employed thousands of forced laborers, including prisoners from concentration camps. Many of these forced laborers died as a result of their inhumane working conditions. Rudolf also belonged to the Nazi Party and the SS. He worked on the Redstone and Jupiter missile programs after moving to the United States and was awarded the National Aeronautics and Space Administration's Exceptional Service Medal. However, after evidence of his involvement in war crimes surfaced in 1984, he was stripped of his citizenship and forced to leave the country. Hubertus Strughold was an aerospace medicine expert and a key figure in Operation Paperclip. He was the chief physician at Dachau's Aviation Medicine Research Center, where prisoners were subjected to cruel and inhumane experiments without their knowledge or consent. He also belonged to the SS and the Nazi Party. He worked on the development of the U-2 spy plane and the SR-71 Blackbird after moving to the United States and was awarded the Presidential Certificate of Merit and the Legion of Merit. However, the U.S. Army investigated him for war crimes in 1947, but no action was taken against him, and he was able to continue his career. Walter Schreiber was a prominent medical researcher who played an important role in Operation Paperclip. He was the German Army's chief medical officer and was in charge of medical experiments on concentration camp inmates. He also belonged to the SS and the Nazi Party. He was awarded the Legion of Merit after working on the development of the B-70 Valkyrie bomber in the United States. However, the U.S. Army investigated him for war crimes in 1947, but no action was taken against him, and he too was able to continue his career. These are just a few examples of the scientists who had been involved in war crimes and violations of human rights during World War II, and who were recruited through Operation Paperclip. It is important to note that many of these individuals were able to continue their careers in the United States without facing any repercussions for their actions during the war because of the secrecy of the operation and the lack of proper background checks conducted by the government of the United States. Operation Paperclip was a secret program launched by the United States government after World War II to recruit German scientists and engineers who had worked on advanced technologies during the war. This operation was critical in advancing American technology and strengthening the US military, but it was not without controversy. Some of the scientists brought to the United States were involved in war crimes and human rights violations during the war, but they were able to continue their careers without repercussions. The legacy of Operation Paperclip is a contentious and dark chapter in American history.